Hello student, I will continue with the chapter determination of the place on the earth's surface. In the last class, I have explained about the water latitudes. Now let us see what are the properties of the latitude. So number one properties of the latitude is that latitudes are present in the north south position, or you can say in other words that the latitude runs in the north south direction. Okay, next is that all the latitudes are parallel to the equator. Okay, so we have total 179 latitudes, and all the latitudes are parallel to the equator, or all the lines of latitudes are parallel to the equator. That is why we also called the latitudes as the parallels of latitude, because they lie at an equidistance or parallelly from each other. Number three is that the parallels of latitude are not, parallels of latitude do not have different value based on their position in the hemisphere. Number four is that the highest possible latitude is 90 degrees, that is the pole. The next point is that at the poles, the latitudes are mere points, because we all know that the North Pole and the South Pole are just points. So these are some of the properties of the parallels of the latitudes. Now let us see about the important latitudes that are present over here. Okay, so the latitudes which are present in the northern hemisphere, we are calling it as the north latitudes, and the latitudes that are present in the southern section of the earth, we are calling it as the south latitudes. So we have total 7 important latitudes. What are those? The North Pole, that is 90 degrees. Then we have the South Pole, that is 90 degrees. Then we have the 66.5 degrees south, 66.5 degrees north, 23.5 degrees south, 23.5 degrees north, and the equator, that is 0 degrees. So these are the 7 important parallels of the latitude that are present on the earth's surface. Okay, so this equator, let us see and learn more about the individual latitude. So I will start with the equator. So this equator is actually an imaginary line which is drawn at an equal distance from both poles. So this is the North Pole, this is the South Pole. So the equator equator is being drawn at an equal distance from both these two places, or from both these two poles. Okay, this equator is actually encircles the earth in the midway, or from the center of the earth, from the center portion of the earth, between the North Pole and the South Pole. It divides that into two hemisphere or into two equal halves, that is the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere. So Northern Hemisphere means the part which is lying above the equator, we are calling it as the Northern Hemisphere, and the portion that is present below, we are calling it as the Southern Hemisphere. Okay, and the value of the equator is 0 degree. It is also known as the Great Circle. Next important latitude is this 23.5 degree north latitude. The other name of the 23.5 degree north latitude is the Tropic of Cancer. It lie at a horizontally at 23.5 degree north of the equator. That is why in the Northern Hemisphere. Okay, and it is also an imaginary line, smaller than the equator. In comparison to the length of the equator, this line is smaller. At on 21st of June, the summer solstice, during the time of the summer solstice, the direct rays of the sun fall in this Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degree north. Okay, and it lies in the Northern Hemisphere. The next important latitude is the Tropic of Capricorn, that is the value whose value is 23.5 degree south. It lies in the southern hemisphere on 22nd December. The direct rays of the sun fall on this particular latitude, and the southern hemisphere have the summer solstice, and whereas the winter solstice is present in the northern hemisphere. Next important latitude is the Arctic Circle, that is 66.5 degree north. It lies at 66.5 degree north of this equator. It encircles the Earth much smaller than the equator. On 21st June, during the summer solstice, the Arctic Circle receives the tangential or the oblique rays of the sun. The entire region beyond this Arctic Circle gets 24 hours daylight during this point of time. The next important latitude is the Antarctic Circle, which is 23.5 degree south. It lies 66.5 degree south of the equator, or based on the equator, its value is 66.5 degree south. It also encircles the smaller part of the Earth during the winter solstice, that is the 22nd December. The Arctic Circle receives the tangential, means this portion of the Earth receives the tangential rays of the sun, and the places beyond the Arctic Circle have 24 hours daytime. Okay, the last one is the North Pole, that is 90 degree north. It is the smallest parallels of the latitude, and it is just merely a point. It is in the Northern Hemisphere, and we have the South Pole, that is also the smallest parallels of the latitude. And it is also a firm, it's also a point. So more or less, these are the 7 important parallels of the latitude that you need to know. So this is the end of this video. I'll continue with the next of the portion in the next video. Thank you, everyone.